the love of God is greater far than tongue or pen.
Happy birthday, bro. You're looking good. I'm going to send you some pictures to see if you have a memory of 80 years ago. Happy birthday.
The lowest hell, the guilty pair, bow down.
Hey, Luther, you must get tired of hearing from me almost every day. You're such a great role model for me and such a help in my fight to stay healthy. I'm so thankful that I've known you for so many years.
Happy birthday, dear Uncle Luther. This is Mary in Minnesota, and I'm glad that I got to partake in wishing you a happy 95th. Wow, congratulations for your 95 years, and just remember that it's not the years in your life, it's the life in your years. And you have had a lot of good life, and keep it up. We just wish you the very best, many blessings this year and in the years to come. Happy, happy birthday.
Happy, happy birthday. Birthday.
Greetings from Minnesota.
Hey, Dad, happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Luther.
It's the shortest day of the year. Bev and I have been thinking a lot about you this week, and we wanted to leave you a quick message just to wish you a happy birthday. We always have you in our mind and our prayers and our thoughts and thinking of you often.
Yeah, I was having a little memory the other day about the time that Paul and Smooth and Biter flew to Nebraska, picked me up in this plane that Biter built, and I flew to Colorado for Thanksgiving. It was a scary, scary flight, but it was also a great weekend because it was the weekend that I got engaged to Paul.
We always enjoy the times that we get to spend together with the family, and I particularly enjoy our one-on-one time when I make trips to see you and stay with you for a week, and I've really missed that this year. I miss our time that we share together. I miss our good conversations that we have. They get a little deep sometimes, usually right after we get out of bed and before I've had a first cup of coffee, but I always hope that at least before we go deep that you've got your hearing aids in, so that's always a good thing. We just know that we can always count on you. You're a man of faith, integrity, and honor, and we love the way that you have always supported our family and shown your love and pride for our family and whatever accomplishments we may have. So we're just really sorry that we had to miss your birthday today and miss Christmas this year, but we'll make it up to you next year, and I'm looking forward to being able to come see you again real soon when we get done with all of this stuff. So in the meantime, we wish you joy, happiness, and peace. Enjoy your Christmas, and we'll be thinking of you often. Take care, and know that we love you so much. Okay, happy birthday.
We're all here to wish you a very, very happy 95th birthday. We have Jamesy, and we have Leo, and we have Zenny. And we all love you so much, and we just want you to have a great birthday and wonderful year coming up. You can now say that you're 96 years old because you have reached your 95th. So love you so much. Bye-bye.
Happy birthday, Dad. Wow, 95 years, what a milestone. The days are sure getting short here. Thank you so much for being such a steadfast father, pastor, friend to so many. Over all these years, you have been a tremendous role model and leader for our family, and we are so blessed by you. Thank you so much, and have a wonderful 95th birthday.
Luther, I love going walking with you. I love all your wisdom that you constantly give, and I love when you talk me off a cliff when I'm going crazy. And anyway, just love that you always point us to Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. That's just the greatest. So happy birthday. We love you so much.
Hello, everyone. Nancy and I are excited to be able to put this on tape of what our feelings are with Luther and our life together with him. As we get together to celebrate his birthday, I've had a chance to reflect on his and my relationship over the last 45 years. I don't know how I could have had a better father-in-law than what I have. It's been an extraordinary time with you. I've thoroughly enjoyed everything about our relationship, and I feel incredibly blessed. You've also raised four extraordinary children, and you and Lois's guidance and your values that you instilled in them pay dividends today with grandchildren and great-grandchildren. You've been a true blessing in our lives, and I feel very blessed to have had you as my father-in-law and be a part of your life as well as you being a part of mine.
Happy birthday, Dad. This is truly a special day. And when I look back on my 68 years, the first word that comes to my mind is gratitude. I am so thankful for the life that we lived as a family and your calling as a minister and your life's partner, Mom, who was also so instrumental in the ministry. For a lifetime, I've been so proud to say I'm a Lutheran pastor's daughter, and I just am wanting to share that with you. I think that having the faith that you've had, the commitment, and the purpose that you've lived your life with has been a tremendous inspiration to all of your family and to all the people through the years that you have mentored. There is in your life a driving purpose to show the world that this family, that you are committed to Christ, and that is the purpose of our lives, is our commitment. And with that life, you've lived it with great joy and great hope. We've shared the hope of eternal life. It's the truth that is the basis of everything that we do and what we believe in, and it gives us incredible peace to know that our lives have been lived in Christ. We can't say enough about you as a father. Truly, I would have to say that there couldn't be a better father on earth, and I am just so proud to be your daughter and to have had an opportunity to grow up in a home with my brothers and sisters, who truly are remarkable people, as are the people that they married and now the grandchildren that we're raising. So my hope is that we can be the inspiration and the parents that you have been, and that we can continue to raise our children in the faith, the commitment, and the purpose in which you have lived your life. God bless you. Many more years.
Yes, happy birthday.
Happy 95th birthday, Grandpa.
Hi, Luther. Your birthday will always be so special to me because your 90th birthday is where I got to meet your entire wonderful family, and now I'm so happy to be a part of it.
It's hard being away from family at the holidays. We miss all you guys so much and hope to see you soon. Hope you have a wonderful 95th birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy 95th birthday, Gramps. You know, it just seems unfair that we would get the shortest day of the year to celebrate a man that clearly deserves the longest day of the year. You're such a blessing to our whole family, and we love you so much. I hope you have the best birthday.
Hey, Gramps. Happy birthday from Philly. We love you and we miss you. Sharing a memory with you today, there's so many, of course, growing up literally with you. I can think of tons as a child that I sat and thought about today and laughed about and really enjoyed reminiscing over personally. But the one I want to share is shortly after Grandma passed, and also shortly after Alouette was born, since they were about the same time, you came out to New Jersey to see us and to meet your new granddaughter, and to also maybe grieve a little bit and share Grandma with us a little bit because we weren't able to travel for the funeral. And it was a very special time for us with you. You know, it was a peaceful and solemn time, and I'll always remember it. That same trip, we actually decided that we were going to take on Manhattan together, as you probably recall. And we walked to the train station. We rode the rails into Manhattan. We rode the rails around Manhattan and grabbed lunch in Times Square, of all places. And to be sitting with my 85, probably at the time, year old grandpa in Times Square having a meal was pretty special. So we loved that trip. I personally feel like it's a very special time. You know, you are somebody that I've always loved and have always felt close with, and I appreciate that you've always been able to allow me to approach with whatever's going on in my life, and you've always given me sound advice and pointed me back to Christ. I love you very much. You're very special to me, and happy 95th.
Happy birthday, Grandma Luther. We love you.
So my favorite memory, or two favorite memories I wanted to share. One is Grandpa Luther officiating our wedding, which was now over 12 years ago, which is crazy. And him telling the story of Andrew as a little kid, coming up to Grandpa Luther and telling him to give him the screwdriver and that he was going to fix the dishwasher. And delivery, everything was absolutely perfect, and we were all cracking up.
And one of my favorite memories is road trips in the full-size conversion van with the Chinese checkers in the back seat and the pedestal and the pilot seats that flipped around and going on road trips across the country with you and Grandma. And my brother breaking his arm on your laundry pole. That was a pretty interesting night as well.
And
we love you.
Baptizing both the girls was pretty special too. Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Hey Gramps, happy 95th birthday to you. I wish we could be there with you to celebrate. It's such a milestone birthday for you, and I know we all wish we could be there. I was thinking a little bit about the many memories that we've created over the last 37 years, and one that really sticks out to me is all the times that you and Grandma would come out to see my bands play as we toured through Denver. From little tiny dive bars to bigger venues like the Ogden Theater and the Gothic Theater, you and Grandma were always there. And I just wanted to let you know how much I really appreciate that. Really taught me that you always show up for your family. And that's something that's stuck with me for my entire life. Really do wish we could be there with you to celebrate the holidays and this momentous birthday. Hope all is well and we see you soon.
Happy birthday, Gramps.
Happy birthday, Gramps.
95 is a big one.
Hey, Gramps.
Hi, Gramps. Happy birthday.
Happy 95th. Wishing you all the best and Merry Christmas, and we love you.
We love you.
Happy birthday, Grandpa. I love you.
Happy birthday,
Great Gramps, we love you because you care for your family and you're a great leader for us all.
I also love you because I like having a lot of conversations with you.
Thank you for fighting in World War II.
I love you and you're the best.
heard you say a mean word about anyone. You are always encouraging. We love you. Happy 95th.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Great Gramps.
I love drinking coffee with you and your friends at the mall. I love eating the candy that you have at your house.
I love that you're a servant leader, that you tell great jokes and send great memes, and that you've been such a great family, a patriarch for all of us, and showing up at all the events and always supporting us when we need you.
I love all the times we've been able to go to church together and dinner afterwards. We're so grateful for you and we love you. Happy 95th.
Happy birthday.
Bye. Bye.
Happy birthday, Luther. Of course, so sad we can't be there with you to celebrate, but maybe we'll get to see you in the spring. I want to share my favorite memory of you, which is when you and Lois came to visit a brand newborn baby Worth the day after we had her. I remember you guys came into the hospital room and you sat on the end of the bed and just kind of held her and fussed, and I felt such a sense of pride in almost like presenting this baby to you guys, and it just felt so celebratory and joyous, and anyway, I just think of it often. And I also want to express a sentiment that I'm sure will be repeated over and over, which just speaks to its truth, but just thank you for what you are and what you represent for the family. You're such a cornerstone of wisdom, but also kindness and respect. I think it's pretty remarkable that I know that, you know, all of us, all the cousins and grandkids, feel really heard and loved and respected by you, which is remarkable because we all look up to you so much. Should do nothing but sit and listen to what you have to say. And so often you'll sit and listen to what we have to say. And that, of course, just speaks to your character. So thank you for what you are and for giving us someone and something to aspire to be. Have a wonderful birthday.
Hi, Great-Grandpa. A memory that I have with you is I remember when I was 4 or 5, sink. Hey, Great Grandpa. My memory of you is when we always go into your house, we always see you a huge pile of treats on the table, and I just wanted to tell you about it. Hi, Great Grandpa. My memory of you is when we went over to your house and you made us Papa Murphy pizza.
Where every star.
Happy birthday, Luther! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, dear Luther! Happy birthday to you!
From sky.